A historical preservation project in Bonita Springs is being called an eyesore after the city already went through a lot of trouble to move it. Now the city is looking to hide it. NBC2's Alex Howard is live in our control room to show us the new plan.
Back in September, NBC2 showed you how the city of Bonita Springs moved this nearly 100-year-old building to the heart of Old Bonita to be preserved as a sort of welcome center. But now, with money short and residents complaining, the city is now looking for ways to hide it from view.
It looks like it's a blighted area now down here.
Albert Engel is the owner of Engel's Out of Line Bait and Tackle Shop on Old US 41. When he found out last summer his store would neighbor the Dixie Moon Cafe, he was excited.
I was very happy. I figured they were going to fix it up. We were going to have an historical site. But what we have now is a nightmare.
The building was moved from its former location back in September as part of a historical preservation project. But now some business owners on US 41 are saying it's become an eyesore.
Well, it's done nothing. That's basically the problem. And half the building is missing.
Since then, it's sat vacant, prompting the city to explore options to screen the hollow building from view while they explore options.
Let's have it screened appropriately and give staff the time to really come back with appropriate proposals of different options to council.
But to others, the building is too important to leave in such a condition.
Because if it stays like that for long, it's not going to last very long. Yeah. It's going to rot away.
In this day and age, I think the citizens of them need to help out too. So maybe we get some funding together or something to help make this move faster.
Now, the issue of setting up a screen and how much it might cost the city will be brought up tonight at the Bonita Springs City Council meeting, which started at 5:30. Live in the studio, Alex Howard, NBC2.
Alex, thank you. The city of Bonita Springs is considering a plan to either repair or remove the wooden footbridge over the Imperial River in Old Bonita. It's on the property known as Bamboo Village, the city looking to sell the land to a private developer. You can see the city staff blocked off the bridge earlier today. They're talking about a plan at tonight's city council meeting. Several drinking fountains at the Cleveland airport are shut down after passengers got sick. Six passengers who were not traveling together all got violently ill on a Frontier flight from Ohio to Tampa yesterday.
They were just coming out of nowhere, just throwing up, sick, throwing up. They come in and, like, in every different aisle.
Really?
It was nasty.
Nasty is right. More than 200 passengers were held in quarantine for about an hour. Officials do not know if it's waterborne illness, but are shutting down the fountains as a precaution.
A women's march in California is being postponed because of concerns it's too white.
Without having the voice of non-gender binary women and women of color, then we don't have the voice of women. We're just postponing it to allow it to be done in the right way and not just the white way.
Organizers of the march in Eureka say they realized there was a lack of diversity in the people who signed up to participate.
Not because we were worried about just white people showing up and attending, but we were worried that the leadership was not going to be diverse. And so this event was just going to be from the perspective of solely white people.
The census shows that white people make up about 74% of that area's population. Organizers say they will do a march for International Women's Day, but first, they need to build a more diverse leadership.
Well, it's been quite a warm and humid start to 2019, and that's how we ended 2018. More of the same for tomorrow, but not for too long. Things are going to change a little bit. Right now, we're at 76 for Bonita, 78 for Cape Coral, but it feels still into the 80s. Our actual temperature has been into the 80s for over a week. It will continue tomorrow as well ahead of a cold front, and that cold front is going to change things up for this weekend. Tonight is comfortable. More of the same of what we've had. Status quo, light winds, 70 degrees by 11 o'clock. Those light winds could create another round of fog first thing in the morning. It'll be rather warm and very close to that dew point, which gives us a lot of indication of our comfort level. Here's where the fog could develop by tomorrow into the morning hour. So notice the time here, 5 o'clock in the morning. Anyone traveling to the other side of the state, give yourself some extra time on the alley because that is going to create a lot of low visibility and the traffic will be slower. By 7, 8 o'clock in the morning, it will continue to build, especially around Fort Myers, Estero, Bonita, and areas inland, also DeSoto and Charlotte counties. And then after the 10 o'clock hour, it will go away. Another beautiful day, another day to enjoy the beaches or maybe the pool or head out on the water. The boating forecast has just been spectacular the past couple of days, and that will continue for tomorrow as well. Not a lot of rain today and not a lot of rain tomorrow. And not a lot of rain with the cold front. I know, it looks like a lot of rain. Absolutely. This is going to be another one of those fronts that as it heads into southwest Florida, just takes all the rain and it washes away. So let's take a look at our future cast. This will not bring a lot of rain overnight from Friday and into Saturday. But what it will do is lower our humidity. We've been stuck with dew points in the 60s and the 70s. That is from sticky up to tropical. That is going to change by Friday into the evening hours. Will peak ahead of that front. But once that front comes on through, our dew points, our air is going to become a lot drier. The dew points plummet back into that comfortable weather. Very typical forecast for both Saturday and Sunday for this time of year in Florida. Mid-70s during the afternoon. A couple of showers possible in the morning from that front. We'll detail that out coming up at 6 o'clock. But where you're really going to notice the difference, because the afternoons are still beautiful, is the overnight low temperatures. You might want a light jacket or maybe be able to open the windows into the overnight hours. Tomorrow morning, still humid and warm. 67 for Fort Myers and Cape Coral. Port Charlotte at 66, 70 for Sanibel. And again, that fog will be out there, especially for areas south and inland. Another mostly cloudy skies at times, and boaters, enjoy another good day on the water. It's a light shot for those inland and bay waters. Here are the next 7 days. We do have another front on the 7 day forecast next week. We'll detail out what that does for our following weekend coming up at 6 o'clock.
Security officer shot and killed an armed man in a Nevada casino. Witnesses alerted security yesterday about the guy with a gun inside the Green Valley Casino. When the guards confronted him, he pulled out his weapon, so they shot him.
The woman who helped kidnap Elizabeth Smart is now living near an elementary school in Salt Lake City, Utah. 73-year-old Wanda Barzi is living in this halfway house, a 7-minute walk from an elementary school. In 2002, she pleaded guilty to helping her husband kidnap Smart at knife point and keeping her captive for 9 months.
It's hard as a community to feel like you're safe and then you're not all of a sudden. And now that's kind of what I'm feeling here. How do we as a community know that the same thoughts and feelings aren't running through her head?
Barzi was sentenced to 15 years in prison in 2010, but was released early on parole in September.
Now to an NBC2 traffic alert. Tomorrow, the Department of Transportation will be working on a traffic light at Metro Parkway and Daniels in South Fort Myers. The right northbound lane of Metro Parkway will be closed south of Daniels from about 9 to 1, so watch out for that. Headed at 6, third time's the charm. People hope a third gem on the barrier islands will be a gold mine.
I didn't grab it. I didn't, like, squeeze it or anything just by touching it.
A dangerous caterpillar showing up in Cape Coral. The warning you need to see next at 5:30.
Am I at the touch? Am I at the ox? Where do you guys want me? Okay, I'll go to the touch, but I won't touch the caterpillar because that's very dangerous. There.
Hidden in plain sight.
Started about a month ago. We saw him on our plant. On our high-
It is small, green, and toxic. More and more people in Cape Coral are seeing this poisonous caterpillar. NBC2's Devin Turk spoke with experts about what to do if you come across one.
Well, check it out. This is the IO caterpillar. Maybe pretty to look at, but be warned, the little hairs right here on its back can break off in your skin and burn for several hours. It was a painful lesson for a Cape Coral family.
Hidden in plain sight.
Started about a month ago. We saw him on our plant, on our hibiscus.
Juan Garcia found out the hard way that the IO caterpillar had taken up residence at his home.
One day I was taking the trash out, and when I grabbed the handle, it was actually underneath it, and it stung me.
The stinging started the second he brushed up against it.
I mean, it was really painful. It was almost like a burning sensation from the inside. I didn't get swollen or anything, but it was just the pulsing pain for a couple hours.
FGCU experts say the IO caterpillar can be found all over the East Coast. They feed on plants, and their back contains venom that can hurt people and pets for hours.
We have two dogs, and it's scary that by touching it, it just stung me for a couple hours. I can't imagine what it would do to my dogs if they bite it or touch it with their paws.
Miguel Resto has seen them in his bushes, too.
It's kind of scary thinking about it, especially, you know, the kids out there playing around. I mean, you just don't know if they can step on one or something like that, so now that they're poisonous, now that I know that, I'll definitely be paying close attention.
FGCU says to use tape to remove the spines, wash the area with soap and water, and use an ice pack to reduce swelling if you're stung. Garcia hopes spraying will finally get rid of them.
Don't touch them. Get a chemical, treat them right away, and hopefully within a few weeks they'll go away.
FWC says they are a native species, and FGCU says we expect to see more of them in the winter because they like our mild climate. They say spraying chemical pesticides or BT on your plants should get rid of them. In the studio, Devin Turk, NBC2.
And there is more than one type of stinging caterpillar in Cape Coral. We have done several stories on this pus caterpillar. You see it here. It appears to be covered in hair. Those are actually venomous spines that will break off and stick in your skin if you touch them. So
yeah.
Stay away.